Yep. This is the mayor of Blacktown. I'm making another video. Because some of you all don't seem to understand the prophetic significance of this Trayvon Martin drama. You don't seem to understand what I've been saying about how Trayvon got blasted because he was mistaken for a thug. And what this represents is how the black community, we have tolerated and instituted the immaturity and the insanity of these so-called gangster rapper thugs, also known as mama's boys, bad boys, and bastards, instead of solving the problem, instead of recognizing the symptoms. Yeah. And like I said, no other community will tolerate bad boys. No other community tolerates immaturity. At no point in history has any community been run by boys, bad boys, mama's boys, bastards. But this is, of course, because we've allowed the Jezebels, the single moms, female-headed household, to run and rule. Like I always say, in the 1960s, black people were doing everything right, but then feminism came along and everything went wrong. I said feminism came along and everything went wrong because, you see, feminism taught black women to believe in women's liberation. I said women's liberation instead of black liberation, like I've been saying in over 200 videos, but you all don't get it. But I think you get it now that Trayvon Martin has made international news, and it's an embarrassment to black manhood in an age when we thought the rise of President Obama would somehow restore the image of black manhood and black masculinity. But now we see that even Obama himself has helped destroy the image of black manhood with his endorsement of gay marriage. Yeah, so we have a crisis in black manhood all around. And this crisis and this tolerance for immaturity has gotten so far, that in even the officials of the NBA had to get on the NBA players about how they were dressing unprofessionally and inappropriately. Yes. And I get all kind of comments from people talking about there's nothing wrong with it. Well, I understand what it represents. Immaturity. It's a generation of boys raised without fathers. Yeah, I had a father. And I remember my father would always tell me to tuck in my shirt and wear a belt. Yeah. Well, my point is, Trayvon Martin, his assassination by George Zimmerman was a prophetic sign. And for those of you who still don't realize that it was a prophetic sign, you're sick people. You're very sick, and you're in the same category as the people who don't believe the Willie Lynch letter. Yeah. I don't blame everything on white people. Even though white people are guilty of a lot of things, but white people are guilty of doing a lot of things to not just black people. And that's my point. And black people are in denial. Yeah. Black men don't even understand the importance of a men's movement. So, the drama between black mama's boys, bastards, bad boys is just going to continue. And the police will just continue to blast you. Yeah. Now, on a couple of occasions, we see that there have been incidents where the bad boys have been shooting back at police. And it's happened a couple of times. I remember there was one shooting where there was a black boy who he shot some police because he says he didn't want to go back to jail. I don't recall where it was right at the tip of my tongue. But I do recall that. It was a couple of years ago. And then, of course, I do recall that a bad boy took a police officer's gun in Chicago and shot the police and shot up into the police station. And then a week later, coincidentally, a bad boy went up into the Detroit police station, and this was all caught on video. Yeah, he shot up the police station, and of course, that was all caught on tape. So what I'm saying is that there is a gender war going on, and I say gender war because it's not just between black men and black feminists, black men and white feminists, black men and the LGBTQ community, lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, queer, blah, blah, blah. It's a gender war between men and boys, good men and bad boys with sagging pants and attitude, attitude that they get from not being raised by men or fathers for the first time in the history of life on this planet. Yeah. Because when we lived on farms, there was always work for not only boys to do, but me. There was always work for somebody to do. Yeah, there was always work to be done. When we had to cut down trees, when we had to plow the land, when we had to herd animals. Yes. Yet, in this modern age, we're all living like the Jetsons, and a lot of hell is breaking loose. But what's sad is nobody seems to understand what the symbolism of all of this is. Yeah, yeah, the black middle class has utterly failed. And this is why it's being considered that we will not reelect President Obama. Yeah, yeah, why should we reelect him? I mean, this is what democracy is all about. We're supposed to be asking ourselves. We're supposed to be comparing the candidates. Yeah. And white people, they may not elect President Obama. And believe me, Romney will get a lot of votes. He will get a lot of white votes. Don't think he's not going to get a lot of white votes. Don't think he won't. Yes. But the point is, black people, we've still got to circle the wagons, and we've got to decide how we're going to save our boys, save our babies. We need to stop trying to run and rule Egypt. Yeah. Yeah, we need to build black towns. And it's sad nobody seems to understand black town. You don't seem to get it. What prominent black person is trying to build a black town? Yeah. So that proves alone. That alone proves we've got a lot of sickness in the black community. Because all of these black people with these college degrees, etc., all they want to do is run Egypt. Yeah. Yeah. They want to be Pharaoh. They don't want to be Moses. They want to be Pharaoh instead of being leaders who led their people to the promised land. Yep. The evidence is overwhelming. Yep. Trayvon Martin. He was assassinated. Why? Because according to Zimmer Boy, Zimmer Man, he fit the description of a thug, a criminal, etc. Yep. And of course, Zimmerman was 100% wrong. But believe me, this thing could get ugly. Yeah. And of course, there have been many, many, many other incidents similar to Trayvon. But Trayvon was just spilling over. That's what that represents. Because these police, they've been fighting back against these thugs. The black thug image that the black community has allowed to become an institution. And like I said, the NBA officials had to get on the NBA players about dressing like immature bad boys. No other man on earth is going to tolerate that insanity of immaturity. All the strong black men, let me hear you say it. Amen.
We declare our